to enable clients to respond quickly to situations that need attention. You must configure a VMS to detect problems and then send emails and text messages to the proper resources. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to assign sounds and priorities to alarms. First, we'll expand the Alarms node, and then click Alarm Data Settings. Using Alarm Data Levels lets customers set up alarms in ways that meet their specific needs. The system is already functional, but it can be customized further. Here, we can add new priorities with level numbers of our choosing, or use or edit the default priority levels, numbers 1, 2, or 3. These priority levels are used to configure the initial alarm priority setting. In the States section, we can add new states with level numbers of our choosing, with the exception of the default state levels 1, 4, 9, and 11, which cannot be edited or reused. These state levels are visible only in XProtect Smart Client's alarm list. In Categories, we can add new categories with level numbers of our choosing. These category levels are used to configure the initial alarm category setting. We can also change the sound associated with high priority. Click the top Windows question drop-down list. We'll choose Windows Exclamation. Let's look at the other tabs. Click Alarm List Configuration. Here, you can determine what information will display in the Smart Client alarm list. Next, click the Reasons for Closing tab. On this tab, we can define your own reasons for closing an alarm. Some examples might be false alarm or authorities called. If we leave this blank, no reason will be required to close an alarm. Click Sound Settings to continue. Click Yes to save the changes. We can use these standard Windows sounds or add new sounds of the file type .wav, but only if the sounds are encoded in Pulse Code Modulation, PCM. You just saw how to assign sounds and priorities to alarms. Visit our YouTube site to view other tutorials in this playlist.